Hello and welcome to the ePremier League Invitational. I'm Adam Smith and I'm pleased to say that I will be alongside Joe Thomlinson and Harry Pinero. This is the fourth game from day one of the tournament. We will be with you for the next 5 days to see who will be crowned the ultimate FIFA 20 player from the Premier League. Joe, last game of the day.
Last game of the day, but we've already seen 19 goals across three different games. Some amazing displays that were started off actually earlier in the day by Neal Maupay. He beat Aston Villa 6-1, and Aston Villa was represented by John McGinn, of course. Arsenal then went through against Watford 4-3. John Franceschi, who is our first celebrity player, by the way, beat Nathaniel Chalobah 4-3. Burnley beat West Ham 3-2. That was Dwight McNeil last game, scoring with himself in the 85th minute to knock out Ryan Fredericks. And the game we're all looking forward to that's coming up in just a moment is Bournemouth versus Southampton. Just a reminder, if you are watching at home, stay home and save lives. The prize fund for the Premier League Invitational Tournament is being donated to the Players Together initiative. And all the teams are on your screen now that are in the competition. We've got Man United, Liverpool, Tottenham against Newcastle. Chelsea will be playing Everton. Manchester City will be taking on Crystal Palace. A top four battle between Wolves and Leicester. Norwich against Sheffield United. And then we've seen Maupay go through already as Brighton beat Aston Villa. And then Arsenal, Burnley will be the game that also happens. But Bournemouth, Southampton is before all of those. It's coming up right now, Spiffy. For the people that have just joined us in the stream, do you want to explain the rules?
Yes, I'd love to, Joe. These are the all-important rules that you need to be aware of. The EPL Invitational is a straight knockout tournament that takes place over 5 days. Each round consists of just one single matchup. Every single Premier League club is represented by either a player from their squad or a celebrity fan. The draw took place yesterday, which Joe just showed us there. On day one, there will be four round one qualifying matches. That is today, and we are heading into our last round one matchup shortly. We then go into the last 16 on days two and three, and the quarterfinals take place on day four. Both semi-finals and the final itself will take place on Saturday, our fifth and final day. Games will consist of 2 6-minute halves, and in the event of a draw, the result will be determined by a golden goal. Every Premier League squad will be 85 rated in kickoff mode as they battle on the PlayStation 4 to find out who is the best player in the league, Joe.
Yeah, I mean, we can have another look at that draw just to detail some of the players that are going to be representing their teams. Some very exciting stuff. Obviously, we've got Philip Billing versus Angus Gunn coming up. A few other notable names that will be taking part. We've got Raheem Sterling versus Wilfried Zaha in the Man City Crystal Palace game. We've got Diogo Jota against Wilfried Ndidi in Wolves versus Leicester. Todd Cantwell, the tournament favourite, will be taking on Lise Mousset of Sheffield United. And like you said, we've already had one celebrity fan, Smiths, play. We've got another playing tomorrow, Tom Brennan. He'll be taking on Trent Alexander-Arnold. And Moussa Sissoko will be returning back to his old team, Newcastle. I'm really looking forward to all of tomorrow's games, but we've got a massive game happening right now, Smithy, between another player who is hotly tipped for this contest, Philip Billing and Angus Gunsmith.
Yes, the South Coast Derby, of course, Bournemouth against Southampton. I'm delighted to say the players, I believe, are with us now. So let's chat to our home team player first. Philip Billing, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, man.
Right, first question I want to ask you is, we were talking throughout the stream today about players that are favourite. We know that players that we think are going to be favourites to win and that are good at the game. And a lot of people in the FIFA community are saying that you are one of the players to beat. Would you agree with that?
One of the players to beat?
Yeah, one of the favourites. One of the favourites for the tournament.
Oh, one of the favourites. Yeah. I mean, I haven't seen the other, so I don't know. I would like to think so. I think I'm all right at this one.
So amongst your Bournemouth teammates, are you one of the best at Bournemouth, would you say, at FIFA 20?
Yeah, for sure, for sure. When it comes to FIFA, then...
I love the confidence there, for sure. What do you know about your opponent as well, Angus Gunn today? South Coast Derby, of course, Bournemouth against Southampton. What do you know about your opponent today?
What about FIFA?
Yeah, about what he's like in the game.
No, I've never. I haven't heard anyone speak, you know, about them. So I just have to see. I'm not too much of how it might surprise me.
Okay, there we go. It's interesting, Joe, isn't it? A lot of players saying they don't know a lot about their opponents, which throws up so much excitement in this tournament because we just don't know what's going to happen. Joe, confident talk from Philip Binning. It'd be fascinating to see how this one unfolds.
Yeah, exactly. Angus, can you hear us okay?
Yeah, I got you all good.
How are you feeling ahead of this one then, Angus? You just heard Philip there talking. Are you feeling confident in your own abilities?
Yeah, pretty confident. But after hearing what everyone's saying about this guy, and hopefully I don't get beaten by too much. That's all I'm saying.
How do you stack up in the Southampton squad then?
I don't know, to be honest. I've never played against any other lads really. But I know a couple of them are probably better than me. But just got to give me best go and see what happens, isn't it?
Can you give us any inside knowledge on your tactics going into the game? Are you going to be playing a specific formation? Any specific players?
Just how it comes, really. Just sort of, you know, put 10 men behind the ball and try and, you know, hit it over the top and see if I can get a good colour tackle.
Sounds like Angus is going for the old style English football here, Smithster.
I love that. Love the honesty. Right, of course, we're going to have a little bit of a quiz to see how much both players know about the game before we get into our matchup. So, Philip, we're going to start with you as the home team. We're going to ask you 5 questions. They're all related to FIFA 20, just to see how many you get right out of 5. Then we'll go to Angus Gunn. So, Philip, are you ready for this? Okay, first up, who do you think is stronger? Out of yourself or Steve Cook, according to FIFA 20?
Oh, I would probably Steve Cook because it's FIFA. So.
You are right. It's very tight, by the way. Billing 76, Cook 78. So you are correct. Well done. First one right. Right. Head to head. Which player is faster on FIFA 20? Bournemouth's Ryan Fraser or Southampton's Moussa Djenepro?
Moussa Djenepro.
It's not. It's Ryan Fraser, 90. Djenepro, 88. So it's very close, but Ryan Fraser is quicker. Next up, interceptions, as we know, are an important part of the game, but who has better interceptions out of Nathan Aki or Southampton's Jan Bednarek? You got Nathan Aki? I can tell you are correct by 1 point. So well done. 2 out of 3. Next up, who is better at shooting for Bournemouth, Callum Wilson, or for Southampton, Danny Ings, once again, according to FIFA 20?
Danny.
You going Danny Ings? Incorrect. It is Wilson. Wilson 78 shooting, Danny Ings 74, which means you're currently on 2 out of 4 going into the last question. And as you're up against a goalkeeper, we want to know who is higher rated, Angus Gunn or Aaron Ramsdale?
Angus Gunn.
It is Angus Gunn. So it's a question that will make you both feel very happy because you got it right and it makes Angus happy as well. That is 3 out of 5. You happy with that? Happy with your knowledge? Getting 3 right?
Yeah, I'm all right. I'm all right with that. But yeah.
Okay, Angus, we go straight into you. 4 or more to win. Both you and Alex McCarthy are rated 76 on FIFA, but which one of you has the best kicking on the game? Best kicking, Gunn or McCarthy, Angus, what are you saying?
Say that again, sorry.
Oh, I thought we lost you. We had a few technical difficulties, but you're back. I thought you were just taking a long time to think of it because you're that competitive in this, which I liked, but I think we had some technical difficulties. So the question one was, who has the best kicking, Gunn or McCarthy, according to FIFA 20? Okay, apparently we have lost Angus Gunn, unfortunately. We have got some technical difficulties, of course. Worth pointing out, we're all doing this remotely from our living rooms. Of course, the important message is you must stay home, stay safe. A lot of hard work has gone in behind the scenes to bring this to you. We will bring you both players very shortly. It's just a few minor technical difficulties. Joe, we'll bring you in here. Good start from Philip Billing there on the quiz. It seemed quite competitive.
Yeah, he seems confident about his FIFA ability as well, doesn't he? You notice how there was no hesitation in saying that, yeah, I'm one of the better players in the Bournemouth squad. So I'm looking forward to seeing Philip Billing step out onto this FIFA pitch, because he's been much talked about by people online. He's played in tournaments in the past, of course. So I think he could be one to watch.
Yeah, let's bring Harry in. Of course, delighted to say with us all week, Harry Pinero, our good friend. There he is. Harry, we've watched some great matches so far. How much are you looking forward to our fourth and final game of day one? And of course, it's a derby match.
Derby match. As we've been speaking about all day about Billing and how good he is. So I'm so excited to finally see it happening. He seems very confident, which he said earlier about, you know, the Bournemouth team saying no one's on his level. So it'll be good to see what he has, and also to see how Gunn plays as well. It's going to be a good game, hopefully. But one thing we know is there's going to be a lot of goals, so it's guaranteed.
Joe, the other thing with this is as well, which we should touch upon as the week progresses, is there must be quite a bit of pressure, because we've seen lots of fans that are involved and that are engaged in this. And obviously, these players, there's only one player representing the team they play for. So there's quite a bit of pressure on the shoulder of all these players being the representative of the football club they play for.
Yeah, definitely. I think for the players, and even more so potentially for the celebrity fans, you don't want to let your team down, do you? The team that you've supported since you were a little kid. We saw Josh Franceschi saying that he'd been going to watch Arsenal since 6 months old. It's been his dream to represent Arsenal, and he's finally able to do so in the Premier League Invitational. So the pressure from the audience, from the players, from the club on his shoulders is massive. I think some of the footballers might be used to it, obviously stepping out every single week and playing Premier League football. But for the celebrity fans, they're not used to having to take the pressure of the fans, of the team around them. So I think the celebrity fans have more pressure than the players, to be honest.
Yeah, it's a good point, because he said he's such a big fan, season ticket holder. And also, interestingly, Harry, he was the one, I think I'm correct in saying, seemed the most stressful and nervous. Pre-match, he said he was stressed. Half-time, he was stressed. He was stressed when he was winning the game. And maybe that is because, like you say, he knows that when football is back sometime, he will be going and speaking to other Arsenal fans. And there's a lot of pressure on his shoulders, isn't there, as a fan of the club?
He's a better man than I am. I can only imagine how he feels representing your team, and then obviously you're not even a player and you lose. But he done well. I think, you know what, with FIFA, it's one of those games where I think stress is what makes you a better player. Because if you're, you know, too laxy-daisy with it, then you're probably going to concede a lot of goals. So we saw with the last game as well, that was a very stressful game. But it presented a lot of goals as well towards the end. So it's one of them ones where you just got to be very, very smart with how you play and what players to play. Sort of like a management game at the end of the day. So, yeah, I don't know how they do it, Smithy, man. But they're better than me, I'll tell you that for free.
Yeah, they're better than all of us, I think. That's fair to say. Joe, let's talk about the favourites as well while we're just waiting for our players to reconnect. As I say, we are moments away from that. So we will be with you, with our players, getting our fourth and final game of the day underway very shortly. Let's just talk about some of the favourites. We've mentioned Neal, Maupay. Philip Billing, we've spoken about a lot. I want to talk about Diogo Jota, because I've heard a few people talk him up in the FIFA community. And we haven't mentioned him yet as well. I think that there's a lot of good players in this tournament. Trent Alexander-Arnold, I feel, is another one as well we know is good. It's very tough to call a winner so early on in this.
Yeah, I totally agree. I mean, Diogo Jota's got a tough tie, though, against Wilfred Ndidi. Wilfred Ndidi is going to be a hard man to get past. And it does often come down to the luck of the draw, doesn't it? We saw Jamie Redknapp in his back garden yesterday with his son doing the draw. And some of the big teams have been drawn against each other in the round of 16. Manchester United versus Liverpool. That will be Trent Alexander-Arnold versus Tom Grennan. That is a very, very tasty affair. And one, a lot of fans probably would like to see him deep in the competition. So I think it does come down to who you draw, to be totally honest. Neal Maupay, he came up against John McGinn. John said earlier, didn't he, that he'd only had 4 weeks worth of practice coming into this, whereas Neal Maupay has played hundreds and hundreds of games of FIFA Ultimate Team, looks a fantastic competitor. We saw the way he builds up from the back, similar sort of style of play to Dwight McNeil, very, very professional. And at the end of the day, he will be happy that he drew John McGinn first round. A nice warm-up game almost for him, whereas some of the other very strong candidates are playing each other.
Yeah, Harry, I think we should also touch upon that as well, about the format of this tournament the Premier League have put on. It's a brilliant format, because it's one game that you lose and you're out, knockout all the way, and only one individual match per round as well. Do you think that the fact that that is the format has meant that we've had so many exciting games? Because so many goals that we've seen in the first three games, it's quite incredible, really, isn't it?
Yeah, 100%, because there's no room for a rematch. There's no room for, like, any sort of disputes. It goes to golden goal as well. It can go to penalty. So whoever's supposed to be the best player will actually win. It's a tough format, and only the best can probably survive. And we're probably going to see that with who actually wins. But no, it's very good. Like I said, Neal Maupay, he got an easy game, but I don't think his next game is going to be the same. I think the level of quality is probably going to get better as the game goes on and on. So I'm excited to see that.
And you said excited there, Harry. I know that you've been very excited to see the animation from the players, the celebrations we've seen when they've scored. It's been good to see, isn't it? Proper competitive, this tournament.
Yeah, do you know what it is? I was going to ask some questions about the celebrations and which ones are the go-to ones, because I've got mine as well. Mine's usually the hand in the air just to see me. Do you know what I mean? So, like, I love to see what players want to do and cartwheels and all of that stuff as well. But I think when it's 2-1, you can't really be doing those celebrations too early, because it can come back and get you, like we saw earlier in those games. So it's a tough one to do at the moment.
Yeah, Joe, celebrations have been good. And of course, the other talking point, I suppose, from the day, Dwight McNeil winning the game with Dwight McNeil scoring the winning goal. I mean, that's just brilliant, isn't it? Something we'll never experience that, because we're not professional players.
Yeah, awesome to see. I mean, that was a game, wasn't it, where you saw Ryan Fredericks just skip celebrations entirely. He pulled the game back and he just went in to get the ball back to the halfway line and start playing again. And I thought he was a very good competitor, actually, Ryan Fredericks. Maybe a little bit unlucky to draw Dwight McNeil so early, who is one of the favourites for the competition. We've spoken about him, obviously, Todd Cantwell-Phillip, who's playing in a minute, and Trent Alexander-Arnold. And, you know, I just really am excited for this game to start now. Bournemouth versus Southampton, Angus Gunn versus Philip Billing. South Coast Derby, it's two teams that aren't really separated by much in the Premier League table as it sits right now. Only 5 points separating them between 14th and 18th. And it's a hotly contested derby, Smithy.
Yeah, it is. How do you see it going, Harry? We've been doing predictions and thoughts throughout the day. Obviously, you know your FIFA. If I had to get a prediction from you for the fourth game, where'd you go?
See, I'm going to be on the fence here, because I'm not too sure if I can judge this, but I think Billing might have it. He might pip it by us, just because obviously he's been playing longer. But I like the underdog, so I'm going to go with Gunn. I'm going to go with Gunn.
Okay, interesting, Joe, from Harry there.
Yeah, that is brave. That is very brave. And we can see the teams being set up now. We have got Angus back in the building, which is great to see. Hopefully the internet connection holds out and we can get a game underway here. Both teams just tweaking their formations, putting the final touches to their tactics. Smithy, what's your prediction then for this? We've heard Harry's. What's your prediction?
Oh, I like the way you've thrown to me just as the players have joined us and they can both hear me when you're asking about the prediction. I would say, I think even speaking to Angus pre-match, Joe, he was very honest about, you know, he didn't know where he sat in terms of the Southampton community, where he is. I think Philip, it's fair to say, would go into this as the favourite, as we said, within the FIFA community. A lot of people talking him up, saying that he is one of the favourites. So I'd put Philip as slight favourite for me going into this, but we've seen some very close games. I think we're going to get goals galore. Philip just edging it for me, Joe.
Okay, so the game is about to start there. Angus Gunn laughing about some of the predictions.
He heard the prediction.
Quite a tight one, I think. Either way, we're excited to see what is going on. That finishing, by the way, from Philip Billing in the arena, looking rather tasty, using Junior Stanislas.
Already. Philip, I'd like to ask you a question. It's Harry here. How do you rate how you look on FIFA?
Hey, mine got kicked in the game.
I think we might have a few more technical issues here. Just trying to get this game started right now. Smithy, let's just come back to you and just discuss what we've seen already today before this game gets underway. What have you made of it so far? Because we are three games deep.
It's been a brilliant tournament. I mean, we've seen, as we all know, every single Premier League team is involved. 18 of the 20 players playing are Premier League footballers, current players for their squad, two celebrity fans, which is throwing a nice dynamic into it, actually. Results so far, Villa 1, Brighton 6. So John McGinn's tournament is over. Aston Villa fans, sorry, that is the end of the tournament, end of the road for you. Arsenal 4, 4-3 winners against Watford. That was a really, really close game. Here they are now. And Burnley 3, West Ham 2. So Josh Franceschi of Arsenal, he's the singer from Yumi at 6, defeated Watford's Nathaniel Chalobah. So again, that is the end of the road for Watford. And then Burnley. Burnley in this game, interesting, we're 2-0 up. This is Dwight McNeil going up against Ryan Fredericks, and West Ham pulled it back to 2-2 before Dwight McNeil got a fairly late winner. So yeah, so many goals we've been blessed with in the first three games. And our last round one match is Bournemouth against Southampton. So yeah, hoping for more of the same, Joe, for this one.
Yeah, fingers crossed. And I wouldn't be surprised if we have. If we've had 7 goals in the first game, 7 goals in the second game, and then 5 in the other one, it's going to guarantee goals. And the winner will face Neal Maupay. And Neal Maupay was unbelievable, putting 6 past John McGinn earlier. Has he been the best player so far today for you, Harry?
Yeah, definitely. In because I can see what he's good at. I'm good seeing that he's good at skills, he's good at shooting, he's good at possession play. So he seems to have it all. But I would like to see him against more tougher positions. So that's why this league is going to be good, because we get to see players play against tough players and players who are not good. But yeah, for me, I think he's been the best player. What about you, Smithy?
Yeah, I'd have to agree with you. I mean, if you look at the score, I mean, 6-1 is so emphatic. And also within that, for people that missed that game, it was 4-0 up at a very early stage. John McGinn actually did well. He made a triple substitution and changed the formation. And he was, well, in his words, he was 1-0 up in the second half for a period of time. He still went on to lose 6-1. But he did turn it around. But I think how Neal Maupay dominated that first half particularly. And he was quite confident in the interview, because we're going to be speaking to every player prior to each game. And we did ask him about his FIFA knowledge, which was very good, but also his FIFA playing ability. And he says that he does play very well. He rates himself as one of the best at Brighton, also saying that he thinks Glenn Murray might be the worst just because of his age, which is quite funny. But you can tell they've got a very good team spirit at Brighton as well, which I did enjoy. But yeah, I think Neal Maupay is definitely going to be... I'd be amazed if he doesn't advance to the latter stages. But what's so great about this draw is... potentially Neal Maupay against Philip Billy is the next fixture. And we've both spoken, Joe, about the fact that Neal Maupay and Philip Billing are two of the favourites, but one of them will be knocked out because, of course, they play each other. And, of course, that is doing a disservice to Angus Gunn, who's about to play as well. So it's so competitive that we've got some potentially mouth-watering last 16 fixtures coming up.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, we were talking to Neal Maupay earlier in the season, weren't we, when we were shooting Making It Pro, and he was talking about how much he plays the game and how keen he is. And he was saying, when he first joined this stream today, he was saying how much he wants to win the overall competition and how competitively he's taken it. He actually said that he was going to watch the Bournemouth versus Southampton game just to try and get a bit of insight into how Philip Billing and Angus Gunn are going to play, because he knows that that's going to be his next opposition. And his style of play means that he can build up from the back. He wants to watch and see if there's any weaknesses in the back line, any weaknesses that he can expose. And we've seen him and Dwight McNeil really put together two very similar styles of play. We're back in the arena now, though, with Bournemouth versus Southampton. Hopefully the internet connection holds out this time. Apologies for any technical difficulties before, guys. Obviously, we are all doing this from home, so we're trying our very best. But we can finally start the game. Bournemouth versus Southampton, the South Coast Derby. The winner of this will go on to play Neal Maupay. It's Philip Billing versus Angus Gunn. Obviously, both teams are rated 85 overall. We are playing on 85 mode, meaning that everybody starts off with a flat playing field with a maximum of 3-star skills. So there's no unfair advantage. I'm really excited for this one, Harry.
So excited. Billing started off with a lot of the possession right now. You can tell that he's very, very smooth on the pad. But, it's going to be a tough... Ooh, it's going to be first shot of the game. It's going to be a tough one. I've got a question for you, Billing. Who is your go-to player for Ultimate Team?
Ultimate Player? Probably name it. Vibration.
Okay. Good answer.
Okay, now we've seen a few good performances so far today. Maupay and Dwight McNeil both putting together a very similar style of play, intricate build-up play, and we can see Philip Billing sort of trying to do the same thing, that slow build-up play, looking to pick Angus Gunn apart around the edge of the box with that killer through ball. It's something we saw Dwight McNeil do very effectively, and Neal Maupay who used Glenn Murray brilliantly, and he's in for the Philly, and it's 1-0 to the day. He puts Bournemouth 1-0 up against Southampton, Smithy.
Yeah, big, big first goal of the game. 10 minutes on the clock. Philip, talk us through that goal.
No, I didn't think I was going to.
So there we go, first goal of the game. 10 minutes gone. Here's Bournemouth 1, Southampton 0. And of course, these two have met already in the Premier League. One game, Southampton and Bournemouth have played each other. Southampton 1, Bournemouth 3 that day in the Premier League. And it was the only time they faced each other. Both played 90 minutes in the game. And it was a famous win. Bournemouth's first ever win at Southampton. It did send Bournemouth third in the table at the time. Friday night game, you remember as well. And Billing got the assist for the second goal. So they've met before. Philip Billing coming out on top that day. Will he come out on top this day, Joe?
Well, he's playing some fantastic football in and around the edge of the box, isn't he? Those turns. Angus is really struggling to keep hold of those turns. But there's still plenty of time left in this game. You know, we're only 15 minutes in. And Bournemouth at the moment are on top. But plenty of time left for this to be turned around. And the winner of this game will go on to face Neal Maupay, who of course won 6-1. In the day's opening kickoff against John McGinn. They're on a difficult side of the draw as well, because the eventual area they could be facing is Todd Cantwell, who's favourite, but Billing's in again, and it's another tap-in. Beautiful back-heel play. Philip Billing is running away with this. Big celebs, Harry.
Oh, and he scored with himself. This is the second player to do this. I mean, listen, this is an absolutely controlling game. He's actually controlled from the start to where we are right now. Absolutely amazing play, Joe.
Yeah, I mean, there's some real expert football on show here, isn't there? He's in again. It's Philip Billing. Oh, big chance with his own character there. I mean, Bournemouth looking sensational right now. And you can see why Philip Billing was tipped by so many, really, going into this tournament as a potential favourite alongside the likes of Todd Cantwell, Smithy.
You can't see the screen.
Yeah, it's great. We've just seen Philip Billing score with Philip Billing. We saw that from Dwight McNeil for Burnley. It's not the only time that Philip Billing has scored against Southampton. He did so against Southampton for Huddersfield last season, you remember. Angus Gunn was on the bench, incidentally, that day. So he scored against them in football, in the Premier League, of course. And now he's done it on FIFA as well, scoring with himself. Man. So big, big moment. And it's been all Philip Billing, all Bournemouth. Bournemouth fans will be delighted watching this so far. Angus Gunn needs to get a grip into this game, or it could be a repeat of what we saw in our first game, Joe.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think it's quite as bad as the first game. Neal Maupay was nearly 4-0 up at this stage, wasn't he? But it's very similar. It's very similar style of play to Dwight McNeil and Neal Maupay, that slow build-up. And Billing has been tipped. We've already spoken about it as an expert player, and it's coming to fruition. He's obviously played in tournaments in the past, hasn't he? He's played in the State into Toto Cup, of course, and now he's playing in the EPL Invitational representing Bournemouth. Angus is just struggling a little bit to get a foothold in this game, Harry.
Yeah, it's very difficult for him to start any sort of rhythm of play. Billing's set up for him to just attack, really, and he's doing really well. A lot of passes are actually reaching their players. So it is difficult. It's one of those games where you've got to get one chance and one goal to actually change the way the game is, but that's going to be pretty hard to do. But yeah, Joe, it's pretty hard for him, man.
Yeah, we've already spoken to Philip pre-game, and we talked about how confident he is. He was saying that he's one of the better players in the Bournemouth squad at FIFA. Whereas Angus, not overly confident. So maybe it's just a lack of confidence at the moment for Angus. But Philip is playing some fantastic football in the midfield, really keeping hold of the ball. And that slow, intricate build-up style that we've seen employed by Neal Maupay and we saw employed by Dwight McNeil really paying fruit in FIFA 20 at the moment. They probably play a lot of FIFA, a lot of foot champs at the moment. So they'll be doing well, and Philip Billing is looking like a serious contender for the overall prize, Smithy.
Yeah, he is. He's one that we spoke about. We said in the FIFA community, a lot of people were talking up Philip Billing, saying he is one of the favourites in the tournament. The likes of Todd Cantwell was mentioned as well. Neal Maupay, of course, we saw earlier beating Aston Villa, John McGinn 6-1. Diogo Jota as well, I feel that hasn't been given enough credit in terms of where he's at. A lot of people saying that he could be one of the players to look out for. So a lot of top players competing in this tournament as Philip Billing has another chance, Joe.
Oh, Junior Stanislas there just stinging the goalkeeper's fingers. And it has all been Billing, really, pushing forward, passing it nicely around the edge of the box, taking his time, looking to pick those openings. And there's another one here. It's Billing again. He's missed some really good opportunities. A few one-on-ones, Harry.
Yeah, a few one-on-ones. It's one of those games where opportunities are just coming so fast that I'm sure he's going to score another one. Now, look at this. We're going to stand absolutely make that together. He might try and get another one before the half's done, but it's been a very, very good start from Joe.
Yeah, we are approaching the half-time whistle now. Angus Gunn looks like he's going to have the last attack of the half. He's managed to get to the byline. Is he going to put the ball in the box? He's not. It's intricate football around the edge. And a goal here could really change the game. But it doesn't look like it's going to happen. And that will surely be half-time. And it is half-time. Bournemouth 2-0 up in the South Coast Derby against Southampton, Smithy.
Yeah, all Bournemouth. I think that is fair to say that Philip Billing did dominate that game against Angus Gunn. 2-0 at the halfway stage, but only two goals in it. We've seen a lot of goals in this tournament. So early goal for Angus Gunn in the second half will put him right back in this game. Philip Billing, interestingly, does become the second player to score with himself after Dwight McNeil did it earlier on today. Harry, thoughts on that first half? Quite one-sided, wasn't it?
Yeah, very one-sided. Philip Billing showing how great he really is. The talk about him before wasn't just talk, it actually is facts. And we're seeing that now. It's pretty hard for Andre Gunn to get into the game, but it's a second half, so we never know how that's going to end. But Smithy is very, very, very difficult for him right now.
Joe, substitutions. We've seen quite a few. We've seen a lot of tactical changes. Do we? Well, we can speak to them now. Philip, any tactical changes going into the second half? Are you happy with the way things are going?
No, I'm just going to keep the same. To be honest, I think pretty good first half. So, you know, don't think.
Angus, not the best first half for you. 2-0 down, but only two goals in it. Are you going to look to change anything going into the second half?
What's that for me?
No, that's for Angus. I think we've got technical difficulties with Angus. Either that or he's so focused about the second half that he's just blocking it out. So we can go back to the game. The second half is underway. I just want to get the game underway. This is what we want to bring you as well, of course, the match action. Second half is underway. It's Bournemouth 2, Southampton 0 in the South Coast Derby. Philip Billing scoring with himself for the second goal. Joe, big first five needed for Angus Gunn if he's going to have any chance at all to get back into this game.
Yeah, big, big second half needed here. At the moment, Philip Billing is sailing through to face the pie, but this side of the draw does feature Todd Cantwell, doesn't it? He'll face off tomorrow, I think, against Lys Mousset of Sheffield United. So that game is going to be a big one to look forward to. And Angus Gunn's hit the bar. It's a great chance. But it's pushed out. Oh, it's a massive, massive chance for Southampton, Harry.
Massive chance. And I always, always say that underdogs should never be counted out. And he started off the second half how we wanted him to start off the first. So we're looking forward to how he's going to continue this game, Joe.
Yeah, maybe we've written Angus Gunn off a little bit too early here because Philip Billing was under pressure there. But as I was saying, this side of the draw is a difficult one. Todd Cantwell's in it. And he is the tournament favourite going into it, really, against Lys Mousset. Although it also features Diogo Jota. Billing's in again. Chance. Good save with his own hands here from Angus Gunn.
Isn't that great to see, Joe? We've seen Angus Gunn make a great save at one end. We've seen Philip Billing score a great goal at the other end. We've seen Premier League players being as competitive as ever playing the game.
He's in. 20. Angus Gunn is in. Chance. He absolutely had to score that chance there, Angus Gunn.
Joe, I'm just
surely,
thinking that
Harry.
It's great for Angus Gunn, Joe.
Surely
to be
he should have scored.
Like this. He's
got to
take his chances.
You've got to take your chances. You can't miss those, especially against a player like Billing. And here we have it again. Here's another chance. It's a tough one. He should have taken that chance. It's a tough game, but chances are few and far between for him.
Yeah, it is a really, really tight game here down on the South Coast. Much more tight than we were expecting, potentially. Angus Gunn's come back into it a little bit in this second half. Struggled to speak to him a little bit because of the internet connection and the technical difficulties. But nevertheless, everybody's doing this from their home, so I'm sure everybody's understanding. And Philip Billing at the moment is going through to face Neal Maupay in what is going to be an absolutely epic game, Smithy.
Oh, I mean, epic is the right word to use, Joe, because I will not be able to separate those two. As another chance, and it's another goal for Philip Billing. What a strike that is. It is Bournemouth 3, Southampton 0, 65 minutes on the clock.
Angus Gunn there calling for offside, but it wasn't to be. It wasn't to be the offside. He doesn't look happy. Philip Billing smiling away there in Bournemouth as they go 3-0 up. Now it's going to be interesting to see. Does he go all out, Angus Gunn, and put it on to ultra-attacking, look to push players forward, or does he just stay as it is 3-0 and hope it doesn't get any worse, Harry?
I mean, it's the only thing you can do at this position because the formation he was using right now has been breached three times by Philip Billing. So I think he has to go ultra-attacking. Hope for the best. There's still time. I mean, if he scores a goal every 7 minutes, then there's a chance. But it looks a bit bleak at the moment for him.
Yeah, I mean, we have seen tactics play a big role, though. We saw Ryan Fredericks nearly come back and complete that comeback against Dwight McNeil, didn't we? We also nearly saw Nathaniel Chalobah come back and overturn Josh Franceschi's advantage. So it should come down to substitutions and the way they play. But Angus Gunn here racing forward. Big chance again for Angus Gunn. Another fantastic save by Ramsdale in the Bournemouth net, Smithy.
Yeah, I was going to say, Angus Gunn himself would have been pleased with that save, I think, Joe. It's been good goalkeeping attributes both ends from Bournemouth and Southampton. But Angus Gunn badly needs a goal in this game. I think he's played all right this second half, Joe. He's had some chances, but two big chances missed. He simply has to take these. There's only 15 minutes left on the clock, and surely Philip Billing will look to wind this down. He needs a goal very soon, or we would expect Philip Billing to advance into the next round. And don't forget, this is our final match from round one, from day one, but loads more matches to bring you over the next 5 days until Saturday, Joe, where we will have the semi-finals and the grand final.
Yeah, exactly. Tomorrow, if you tune in, here's a chance, by the way, for Philip Billing, but he doesn't take it. If you tune in tomorrow, you're going to see Raheem Sterling versus Wilfried Zaha, a clash that has been much talked about online. Philip Billing's in again, though. We'll also see Manchester United versus Liverpool, Chelsea versus Everton and Tottenham against Newcastle that will see Moussa Sissoko return to face his old side, a contest that I'm really looking forward to, actually. So tomorrow has some incredible fixtures penned in, so make sure you tune in for those games too. But right here, right now, it looks like Philip Billing is going to go on to face Neal Maupay, Harry.
Yeah, it does look so. It's been a thoroughly entertaining game here today. I think he's been in control of the game so far, from start to finish, really, at this point. But, you know, Angus Gunn did show a good start to the second half with that amazing opportunity. But it's been one of those ones where you have to take your chances. And that hasn't been the case today. But he's got a chance here. But yeah, Joe, it's been a good one.
Yeah, I just wonder whether Neal Maupay, who said that he was going to be watching this game, has managed to pick anything up from this Philip Billing performance, whether or not he's seen any chinks in the armour, Smithy.
Yeah, it's great to see, isn't it? Well, this is why it's such a fantastic event. Every single Premier League team is involved. Some of the biggest names in the Premier League, and also the Premier League players that aren't involved are watching to look at the opposition. So it's just had absolutely everything, this game. It's straight knockout, which is meant for exciting end-to-end action, goals galore. And the fact that, as you said, we've got some of the biggest names in the Premier League, plus some celebrity fans playing against each other, but also watching and observing. It's just set to be a great day. And you mentioned the fixtures that we're looking forward to tomorrow. Man City versus Palace, Man United v Liverpool, Chelsea v Everton and Spurs versus Newcastle. I mean, what a day in store we've got tomorrow as we approach the final stages of this game. And it's another goal. Joe, Philip Billing is running riot 4-0 in the South Coast derby.
Yeah, fantastic play by Philip Billing. And he scored with himself yet again, hasn't he? That front post finish that is so synonymous with FIFA 20 coming forward there. Brilliant goal, 4-0, game over. And Philip Billing is dancing, Harry.
Well-deserved performance. I mean, from start to finish, like I said, he was amazing. Got two goals with himself as well. Something that no player's actually done. So that's a record that he's created for himself. And I know he's really happy with himself. Great performance.
Yeah, Philip, I don't know whether you can hear us now. What did you make of that performance? What did you make of your performance there, Philip?
It was all right. Still gave a few chances away, to be fair. You know, gave a few silly. He could have scored a few goals. So do I need to tighten up my defense?
Yeah, and obviously you're going to go on to face Neal Maupay as well over the next few days. I don't know whether you caught his game earlier. He put 6 goals past John McGinn. Are you going to have to change anything for that Brighton fixture?
I think just have to be better defensively, to be honest. I think that I was a bit sloppy at times. We could have scored a few goals. So for that game, I'm going to be looking more, you know, towards Ben a bit better.
There we have it then, Smithy.
Yeah, big thanks to our players. Thank you both for joining us. Thank you both for the game. Congratulations to Philip. Joe, it's just, again, sums up the how great this tournament is. We've just seen Philip Billing score with Philip Billing against Angus Gunn, and Angus Gunn was in goal. So it's just been, I mean, a great watch, hasn't it? And a perfect game to conclude day one, I feel.
Yeah, brilliant way to end the day. The first clean sheet we've seen as well today, which is good to see, because the other games have featured so many goals. So maybe that's a little sign that Philip Billing is slightly stronger defensively than some of the other players we've seen so far today. But some massive matchups coming tomorrow as well.
Yeah, Harry, what's your thought? We've seen obviously 4 matches, 8 players now, 8 teams in total. Who do you think you've been most impressed with of the 8 teams that we've seen in action?
I have to say Brighton and Bournemouth for me. 2 of the best players, individual players, for me actually have been Neal Maupay and Philip Billing. They've dominated the game from start to finish, and I think that's the level that it's going to be, and it's going to be a great game for them. I can't wait to watch that game actually, because that game is going to probably be a blockbuster. And as you said earlier, Smithy, one of them is not going to be able to actually win this trophy, so it's going to be a bit difficult for one of them to take it, so I can't wait to see that as well.
Yeah, here is confirmation of day one. So that concludes all of our action from day one, and it also concludes all of the matches from round one as well. So here's confirmation of all of those games. Brighton emphatic 6-1 winners. That was Neal Maupay against John McGinn, as we've mentioned there. Our first celebrity fan involvement was John Franceschi from Umit 6. He dispatched of Nathaniel Chalobah of Watford 4-3. Very, very exciting game that was. Burnley's Dwight McNeil scored as Burnley's Dwight McNeil to beat Ryan Fredericks of West Ham 3-2. And then, as Joe alluded to there, the first clean sheet of the day, Philip Billing, one of the favourites of the tournament, beating Angus Gunn of Southampton 4-0. So this is what it means for the draw. As we said, that is all of our round one games completed. Just to reiterate, 8 teams had to enter at round one. Based on the draw that was done by Jamie Redknapp, the other 12 teams entered at the last 16 phase, which means we now know all of the teams that will be in the last 16. And the teams that won today were Brighton, who will play Bournemouth in the last 16, and Arsenal, who will play Burnley in the last 16. So many games that we are looking forward to, as we said. Let's have a look at tomorrow's fixtures. Look at the teams in action. Manchester City against Crystal Palace. That is, of course, Raheem Sterling against Wilfried Zaha. Manchester United will play Liverpool. Another Trent Alexander-Arnold, of course, playing for Liverpool. We know that he's another favourite, another player that is a keen FIFA player, and we've spoken with him in the past about his knowledge of FIFA. We expect him to be go very far in this tournament, but he has to get past Man United's Tom Grennan first. Chelsea's Reece James is up against Everton. Andre Gomez representing Everton, and Moussa Sissoko for Spurs against his former club Newcastle, and more specifically Christian Atsu representing Newcastle United. Joe, I mean, I feel bad even asking this question. Is there a particular game you're looking forward to tomorrow? Because it's 4 absolute blockbusters, isn't there?
Yeah, very, very tough to call. I think maybe Manchester United versus Liverpool. I think the pressure on the celebrity fans is massive, and we know that Trent Alexander-Arnold is a very, very good footballer and a very, very good FIFA player. So I'm really looking forward to Tom Grennan versus Trent.
Harry, what about yourself? It's been great to see, obviously, we've had so many fans getting involved and watching the stream. What are they saying? Who do they feel is the favourite, having seen all of the action in day one?
A lot of them are rooting for Brighton's Neal Maupay, just by the way he was playing the first game of today, which was an amazing game. So a lot of them are rooting for him. But of late, we've had a high surgence of Philip Billing fans. So it's going to be great. I'm looking forward to the game tomorrow between two of one of the best wingers in the league, the Palace and the City game, to see how great that's going to be. We've seen battles with them on the field, so it'll be good to see it on FIFA as well, man.
Yeah, it's been a fantastic first day's play. That does complete round one. Big thanks from myself, from Joe, and from Harry. We hope that you all enjoyed the broadcast. All of us at home, of course. We'll be back tomorrow at 12 o'clock. Our first game, Man City against Crystal Palace. Wilfried Zaha against Raheem Sterling. It should be absolutely fascinating. Please don't forget to stay home, stay safe, save lives. Thank you for joining us. We'll be back tomorrow. Bye-bye.